But
DJ
hey,
coming
he
out.
Can put it on his resume that he has opened officially for our first guest tonight, mm-hmm. who is one of the hottest new stars in country music, don't you think?
Mm-hmm. You know who we're talking about?
No.
I didn't think you would, because so you haven't seen the rundown. You don't know who's coming up
right.
here. I think the song is called Teardrops.
Yes, and it was the song that introduced this man to the world of country music. Here is George Ducas. Thank you very much.
City Tonight with Crook and Chase, brought to you by Kelly Springfield, America's oldest tire company. We'll be right back.
Howdy, welcome to Music City Tonight with Crook and Chase. Glad you're visiting and watching with us tonight. And we see one of the bright new stars in country music, George Ducas, who opened the show too, right? I know we've been trying to arrange to get you on the show for quite some time, but basically for the last 8 months, you have been touring almost nonstop with some of the biggest stars in country music. So.
That's really true. Yeah, I know we've been trying to get together on this thing for ages, what seems like an eternity. But yeah, I've been on the road pretty much nonstop, and I'm trying to remember who my friends are when I come back in town. It's like,
oh, yeah.
Jack, let's see.
No, you got to tell the folks about the first show. The first show you did with your band.
Oh man! Wow, that was a pretty wild and crazy affair. That was what I would consider to be truly a lifetime, you know, experience.
And was this last year?
This was last year. My record had just come out. This was, I guess it was August. The single had just come out, and I think the record wasn't even in the stores yet. It was going to be coming out a couple weeks later, And
so
I was opening.
Brand new.
Oh yeah. I mean, I'd never played a show before, not even in a club, nothing. So we got the first show offer was opening for Alan Jackson, a couple shows in Dallas and in Houston, and it was a crazy affair because on Monday I rehearsed with the band. I had a band leader, you know, my guitar player, and he hired the rest of the band because I was on tour visiting radio. Mm-hmm. Anyway, we rehearsed on Monday, 6 or 8 hours, rehearsed on Tuesday, 6 or 8 hours, took Wednesday off. Wednesday night, midnight, we leave, go down, drive down to Dallas, and there we are in front of 15,000 people, my very first show, you know.
Good, great.
And there was about a 3-second stage there where I thought, I don't think I can do this.
Yeah.
So, I bet you couldn't breathe when you first walked out there, much less sing.
Once I got out there, I was fine. I don't know if y'all have ever been through the jitters before, but it's kind of like when you sit down for a final exam or something mm-hmm. like that. And you just, you know you can't do it beforehand, and then you get in there and yeah. everything's fine.
Cool.
Speaking of final exam, we were talking backstage, and we found out we have something very important in common.
We both
graduated from Vanderbilt University here in Nashville. Now, what was your major?
I majored in... Believe it or not, folks, economics.
Economics.
You did. Mm-hmm. Okay, and I majored in foreign languages, Russian and Mandarin Chinese.
Well, so it's so only obvious.
I'm serious.
So it's only obvious
is
both of you end up in show business, right?
No. No, I did. Yeah.
Wow.
You think I'm teasing you?
I didn't know we had those majors at that school.
Well, he was busy studying heck, you know.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. So, I mean, did you live on campus? Did you do the whole campus thing?
I lived on campus, you know, and everybody thinks that I went to school there, you know, because it was located in Nashville, and it would give me sort of an in with the music business, which is not true. I unfortunately was not one of those bright kids that knew, you know, from the age of 5 or 6 what they wanted to do or be for the rest of their lives. It took me a long time to figure it out, and I didn't figure it out till after college.
Well, now, wait a minute. Let's go back to when you were 12 years old. We were told that's when you wrote your first song. You're 12 years old. What was the name of the first song you wrote?
You're going to make me look bad here, Charlie.
No! Just tell them what the name of the first song you wrote at age 12.
It was called Women and Whiskey.
Women and Whiskey at age 12.
There you go. I knew it. See, I told y'all he was going to make me look bad.
No,
I'm shocked. I am shocked.
I wish you could. Can you do a little bit of that?
I want to hear
don't
it.
Don't take it personally.
Can you do a little bit of that?
Well, I don't have a guitar with me. Oh, man.
Okay, let's go back. You're 12, you're 12 years old. You're writing your first song.
Presto. I don't have a pick.
Don't worry about it. Use one of Lorianne's fingernails. Here, get my fingernail there. No,
I'll play you this is a little rendering here of it, just about half of it.
Okay.
All right, that's fine.
He was a rugged man from his big felt hat to the tips of his boots. He didn't have a trouble in the world. He had a fine woman, too. Until one day she left him, he was so blue. He turned into a drunk and a bum, and he went crazy too. Singing women and whiskey, they're both so risky. They're both good for nothing wrong. Women and whiskey, they're both so risky. And they both make your bill fold small.
12 years old.
When your mama and daddy first heard that song, they must have been worried sick about you.
Yeah, I think they were a little concerned. You know.
Yeah.
Now, you all have to take into account that I was 12 when I wrote that song.
So well, who influenced you?
Bill Fold Small was the only rhyme I could think of to rhyme.
But it works. That's the scary part.
Yeah, it does.
Who influenced you to start writing, and especially about women and whiskey?
Yeah, well, Willie Nelson was the guy. And obviously, I knew nothing about either of those subjects at the time, but... Mm-hmm. As the story goes, he knew enough for both of us.
So. There's the influence.
And
that's
still
right.
does.
And still does. That's
well,
right.
This is an excellent album. It is self-titled, and the man co-wrote every single song on it, and he'll do more for you later on the show. Hot new guy in country music, George Ducas. He'll be back a little bit later. Country music, as we were telling you, he has co-written every song on his album. He'll probably do that on many albums to come.
Mm-hmm. You know, he's always refreshed. Supposedly, he jogs like 4 miles a day. Did you jog earlier today? He's over, huh? Yeah, anyway.
He's getting into his performance.
Yeah, he's all set. Lipstick Promises, top 5 recently from this album. Here again, George Ducas.
Thank you.
Your scarlet kisses on my skin.
For George Ducas coming to a city near you. Now, you won't believe what's coming up next with extortionist Craig Cargas right here on Music City Tonight.
Everything's down.
Are you ready? George Ducas!
Another one and only, but I'll move on and do my best. You'll find me where it's sad and lonely. In case you need my new address, I'll be here at 1313 Heartbreak Avenue. Hello, crew world, my new If I may.